SolarMax, #250, SolarMax. Monthly payment available. For credit details, visit solarmaxtech.com. CSLB number 97204.
The path your life has followed has taken you far. But getting from where you are today to where you want to arrive tomorrow takes a financial plan customized solely for you. Guided by your personal private banker, your dedicated team of advisors at BBVA Compass will provide financial solutions and comprehensive wealth planning. BBVA Compass Global Wealth, creating opportunities for you and your family every step of the way. For more information, visit bbvacompass.com/wealth. Financial planning services provided by BBVA Compass. BBVA Compass is a trade name of Compass Bank, member FDIC.
Looking for a movie that will tug at your heart? Papa, winner of the 2018 London International Film Festival, is such a film.
Whenever I see a father-son theme playing, I just get jealous.
Paul Sorvino, Daryl Hannah, Frankie Avalon, Eric Roberts, Michael Madsen, Misha Barton, and Anne Margaret star in Papa, based on a true story about a son's quest to find his biological parents.
My father, neither of them will give me any.
Go to papamovie.net for tickets, theater listings, and other information. Written and directed by Dan Israeli. Rated R. In theaters this Friday.
Summer is around the corner, so don't let varicose veins hold you back from wearing shorts, skirts, or swimsuits. Quest Medical can transform your legs in minutes without pain or downtime with their advanced varicose vein solution. Varicose veins can't heal on their own, so don't wait. Their vein treatment is covered by most PPO health insurance plans. Call 1-800-WESTMED for a free insurance verification. Call 1-800-WESTMED. That's 1-800-WESTMED or visit WestMedical.com.
$1 billion, which is cheap, because in terms of Los Angeles, our metro system, it's $1 billion a mile, or a yard. All right, now, here's what's going on in the world of the asylum rules. As you know, the federal government, Jeff Sessions, just announced that we're going to make asylum pay for the illegal immigrants based on up, economic hardship, getting destroyed, families being shot up by the gangs in Central America, particularly. That's not the basis for asylum anymore. Okay, that's one issue. Another huge issue is the separation issue. There has been an upturn in separating illegal aliens who come over with their families and separating them out. Oh my God, that's horrible. And it is. It's horrible and terrible. But here's the part that's being left out. The law, which demands separation. And Wayne, let's go through it. This is a federal issue, federal criminal justice system. And of course, you are all over that. I've been in the federal criminal justice system for years and years and years. Everyone is talking about this, like the politicians. Every single one of them is leaving out a major chunk of the truth. Obviously, each side is leaving out a different part. This actually goes back to 1985, and a couple of immigration rights groups sued the federal government. The case was called Flores versus Meese. And they said, you cannot keep minors in these immigration detention centers, even with their parents. And the litigation went on for years.
And what was the rationale?
That the conditions are deplorable and that basically for minors it's inappropriate.
All right.
And this went on for, I think, 12 years until finally there was a settlement. It's called the Flores Settlement. And the government agreed that they would not hold minors at these detention centers and that they would release them. They would prioritize releasing them. And the order, they would try to do it this way if they could. The first choice would be to release them to their parents if that was possible. The next would be to another family member or designated caregiver, but if not, they would have to find the least restrictive alternative. So, here we fast forward another decade or so, and the ACLU sues